my fellow Alabamians, I offer my heartfelt apologies for my participation in something from 52 years ago that I find deeply regrettable. I will do all I can going forward to help show the nation that the Alabama of today is a far cry from the Alabama of the 1960s.
The recording that revealed the governor had worn blackface was an interview with Ivey and her then fiance, Ben LaRavia. For more on that and the response from both sides of the aisle, we go to WVTM 13's Bria Douglas.
Guy, in a nutshell, some Democratic legislators are calling Governor Ivey's actions racist, while Republicans dismiss it as an incident from more than 50 years ago. A chapter from Governor Ivey's past reopened after a college interview from 1967 resurfaced. In it, her then fiance Ben LaRavia talks about a skit Governor Ivey was in.
She had on a pair of blue coveralls, and she had put some black paint all over her face, and she was, we were acting out this skit called Cigar Butts.
Would you like to defend yourself from this low position that he's placed you in now?
Well, that was just my role for the evening.
A role Ivey since regrets, but Representative Wanda Lynn Gavan believes it still represents who she is.
When people show you who they are, believe them. I believe Kay Ivey. I think that she is that person that blackface represented, a racist person.
The Alabama GOP disagrees with Gavan. In a statement, the party supports Governor Kay Ivey taking ownership and responsibility for the 50-plus-year-old incident, crediting her for a video admitting a mistake she doesn't remember.
Why be a coward and not be able to stand before the people? It's the people that elected you, not that video.
When asked if it's possible Governor Ivey's changed since her college days in the 1960s, Gavan had this to say.
How many African Americans, how many did she pick to serve in her cabinet?
The GOP says her extraordinary record of public service shows her ability to work with all people, regardless of race, religion, or party affiliation. Representative Gavan says she's received a phone call from someone from Governor Ivey's office offering an apology for the blackface incident. We reached out to a number of Republicans, all declined to comment. Guy?
Bria, thanks.